Hello, I'm Julie Zerwic. I'm the Dean at the University of Iowa College of Nursing, and I have the pleasure of serving as the co-chair for the Nursing Essentials Implementation Steering Committee. Competency-based education focuses on where we want our students to be at the time of graduation. So we're focusing on having students practice ready. We've worked very closely with our practice partners throughout the whole development of the AACN Essentials to ensure that we understand where our students need to be successful as a new graduate nurse in practice. So competency-based education, competency-based assessment is going to ensure that our students are successful in their new graduate roles. In order to successfully implement competency-based education and the nursing essentials at your institution, there will be a number of individuals that you will want to engage with. Your provost and president will be key to having an impact in terms of the essentials at the institution. You will want to inform educational committees, those that are implementing new curriculum when are important for the approval of this process. Those individuals, the sooner you can engage with them and talk to them about what you are trying to accomplish with the essentials will pave the way for future success. Communicating the value of competency-based education is extremely important as you go through this process. You are going to want to first engage with your practice partners and talk about what is competency-based education and how that's actually going to impact your graduates as they transition into practice. The term having your graduates practice ready will resonate with your partners. They too are committed to having a successful transition from your educational institution into the practice setting. This requires that we have a close relationship with our practice partners. So working with our practice partners will ensure that they're comfortable where our graduates are as they hire them as new graduates, and we will know exactly where they need to be at the time of graduation. That relationship between an educational institution and a practice partner, or maybe several practice partners, is essential for the success of competency-based education. There are many stakeholders that are going to be involved in the success of implementing the nursing essentials. For example, your faculty are a key partner in this process. The faculty will need to think about the curriculum, map the curricular concepts, and ensure that the curriculum meets the requirements of the new essentials. As the curriculum moves through the university, you will want to engage partners such as your provost or president, your curriculum committees that are at the university level, to ensure that they also are well informed about what you're trying to accomplish as you develop this new curriculum. There are other partners such as your alumni, potential donors, who you will want to keep engaged and let them know what you're doing and how you're accomplishing this new curriculum. There are other campus partners. For example, you may want to engage individuals in your disability offices to find out what this curricular change or what impact this curriculum change will have on individuals or students that have accommodations. State boards of nursing, state legislators, those are individuals who also are very interested in how students are being prepared and how successful they are as new graduates. So keep your state individuals informed about what you're doing and how this will actually improve your practice-ready new nurses. You have a number of products that you may use in your curriculum, and you have business partners or vendors who supply you with those products. Engaging them in what your needs are and what you're trying to accomplish will help them design their technology to match what you need with your curriculum. AACN has a number of resources that are readily available to help you with the implementation to the Nursing Essentials. On their website, they have toolkits, they've housed a number of webinars, they describe regional workshops that have been offered as well as are continuing to be offered around the country to prepare faculty for competency-based education. They also have talking points, documents that you can use with your practice partners, your development officers, as well as talking points for students. Students are going to be very interested in how this change in the Nursing Essentials is going to impact their education. These talking points will prepare your admission officers to talk with both their students as well as their families on this important change. All of these resources can be located at the website for AACN, and these resources are constantly being updated. So you will want to return again and again to see what new materials are available for you as you transition your curriculum to the Nursing Essentials. The Nursing Essentials is going to be transformative for nursing education. I am very excited to start this journey with my faculty and our students, as well as our practice partners, and I hope you will be as well.